Hey guys, my name is Shelby. I'm the founder of Unsilenced. A little bit about me. I grew up here in Texas. I have struggled with depression, anxiety, autoimmune diseases, domestic violence, stalking, academic struggles, paranoia, PTSD, and complex PTSD. And up until last October, I had no reason to think that this was caused by any one thing until I heard VCUG for the first time. I had a lot of issues as a child. I was bullied, did not have a ton of friends, undiagnosed ADHD until I failed out of college. And my earliest childhood memory is a brief snippet of being potty trained, followed by this recurring childhood nightmare, where I'm laying strapped to a table and men are hovering over me in surgical masks, violating my lower body. I convinced myself it was a nightmare and moved on with my life. When I heard about this procedure I had, it took me less than 2 seconds to connect all of the dots and think, I knew it. I knew it. Something has always felt very wrong with me my entire life. I've never been able to put a finger on what that was. So as much as this healing journey has very much sucked, it was very necessary. I will absolutely benefit from having figured out this very vital information that has dominated every waking minute of my life. And now I know why my brain does the things it does, such as dissociating, black and white thinking, paranoia, trust issues, all that fun stuff. So, today, I wanted to finally sit down and tell you guys exactly what my organization's mission is and what we intend to do. So, the VCUG is a pediatric diagnostic test that typically is done in a hospital or radiology clinic. The vast majority of these procedures are performed on kids who are toddlers or preschool aged. Many, many children end up getting more than one. Some were forced to get one every single year, usually around their birthday, for several years of their life. Before I go any further, I just want to remind people that this is a very, very complex trauma. Like every other survivor in our group right now, I am unable to go into extreme detail, nor talk about it for very long. That's a balance I'm still finding out. And the reason myself and the other girls I've been so blessed to connect with are so disturbed to discuss this, let alone tell people about it at all, is because what we experienced was essentially the same trauma as a violent rape. And those are not words I am pulling out of thin air. Those are not words I just made up to describe my personal experience. Those were the words used in a very credible, very well-performed study from 2014, almost 10 years ago. Of course, that was one in a very long line of studies that have been coming out since the 1990s, comparing the VCUG procedure to sexual abuse, because that's how pediatric patients process this test. And I beg you to go look at the studies right here on our website. We are in the process of getting them all posted. There are a ton. But hopefully that will give you a better idea of what we're dealing with here. And to think that hundreds of thousands of these are performed on kids every single year is absolutely insane. I wasn't sure what to expect when I started this group. To be honest, I just got this laughable urge to reach out to all the girls I had met on a subreddit, the only forum at the time that mentioned VCUG trauma, and saved my life at the same time because I thought I was alone. When I was 2 years old, my brain could not accept the fact that I was unable to prevent this thing from happening to me. And so it got rid of that memory, a phenomenon known as dissociative amnesia. A lot of doctors will try to argue that children forget early childhood memories. There is evidence that this is not the case. And if academic literature is not your thing, you're welcome to look at myself or any one of our girls in our group currently who went through the exact same thing, forgetting it happened, and then remembering everything when they're reminded of it later. The fact that multiple women have reached out to me in the few short months we've been making this organization happen to say, hey, I forgot about this procedure until I came across your TikTok or your Instagram or your website. Upon reading the material on your website, everything came rushing back. On one hand, I am responsible for putting other women through the exact same experience I had last October, and that was single-handedly the worst experience of my life. I genuinely believed it was not going to get better. I wanted to take my life more than I ever have before. Here I am, not fully healed, but in a much better place and blessed with so many strong women surrounding me and lifting me up and telling me it's okay. It's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay to take risks. It's okay to be brave. It's okay to speak your truth. And most importantly, it's okay to take breaks. I'm so grateful for this community for being so patient with me as I'm also healing from this trauma. It's unimaginable to think that what I put online is prompting girls to relive that same awful, awful cycle. But I have to remind myself that this is necessary. Until we know what happened to us and how it impacted us, we can't fix it. So many of us have just gone years or decades struggling with so many issues and having so many questions and thoughts and feelings of defectiveness and feeling that we're unlovable. If you haven't watched this TED Talk, by Nadine Burke-Harris. I highly recommend you watch it right now or as soon as you have the time. It is very, very important. We need to be talking about this. ACE, or adverse childhood experiences, have significant outcomes on physical health, especially in adulthood. So many people suffer medical issues from unknown causes due to childhood trauma. I've had health issues for as long as I can remember following this procedure. Ironically, I did not, in fact, have the disease that this test is designed to diagnose. And that makes me the only one in my organization currently who didn't have it. This was not a necessary test for me to go through. I am extraordinarily blessed to have found this second family that gathered around me to lift me up when I really, really needed it, when my own family turned their backs on me, when my friends didn't understand. My girls did. Not one of them lives in my state, but I feel like I've known them for my entire life. I cannot tell you how enlightening it has been to speak to other VCUG survivors who did have VUR. This is a condition that kids are born with, where one or both ureters are too short. This causes urine to be pushed back up into the kidneys. As you can imagine, this can be extremely serious. It can lead to renal scarring. It can even lead to kidney failure. We are not here to ban any procedure. We are not here to tell parents and their children what medical care they can and cannot have. That is not our job. It is not our right. And that would be an absolute overreach on our part. There are four truths that are all contributing to why we're standing up today. I can only assume that this information has either gone unnoticed for decades, or medical personnel and other defenders of this procedure have successfully silenced families from speaking out about the long-term ramifications of this test. We have conducted extensive research on this test, and not just in the United States, but in various other countries as well, including Israel, Austria, and South Korea, to name a few. Throughout this extensive research, a few things have been made shockingly clear to not just myself, but the parents and the survivors in our organization. One, the VCUG test is overperformed. The question of medical necessity is anything but uniform and anything but honest to families. There is no VUR foundation, which has shocked a lot of us considering how many families and children are impacted by VUR. So there's really no way for parents to know the truth. That's why we had to go hunt it down. And the truth is, there is no well-documented agreement or recommendation in terms of VCUG follow-up, frequency, and medical necessity. VUR is, like most rare diseases, a real doozy. There are 5 grades of VUR, and in the majority of cases, low-grade VUR resolves spontaneously. In boys, it usually happens before age 2. Unfortunately, this is not the case for girls. So even girls with low-grade VUR, which is obviously something to keep an eye on, but maybe not undergo multiple VCUG tests, have been forced to do so anyway, and are forced to do that today. There is not enough conversation regarding the medical necessity of this test. Medical organizations have an obligation to weigh the pros and cons of a given treatment before administering it to any pediatric patient. There are many cases in which the cons easily outweigh the pros. My case, for instance, I was 2 years old. I had a couple UTIs. I had just been potty trained. I was not wiping correctly. And as absurd as that sounds, it makes sense I got a couple UTIs. Unfortunately, I had to reap the same psychological effects of a violent rape because I didn't wipe correctly. And that is a burden I will carry until I am dead in the ground. And that's still so hard to admit. Our second point is that there are viable alternatives to this test. Let me be very clear. I am not a medical professional. I acknowledge and understand that the VCUG as a diagnostic test may be more accurate, better known. Professionals are more experienced in performing it, probably because they've been calling it the gold standard since the 1990s, with no changes, no updates, no nothing. That is all well and good, but there are many kids, potentially hundreds of thousands of kids, who do not require a VCUG test. It is not medically necessary. One study even goes as far as to say that kids under a certain age do not need this yet. 2 to 24 months old. This should raise some eyebrows. VUR families deserve all the facts. And that includes alternative measures. It does not matter if these alternatives may or may not be slightly less accurate, especially considering there is no standardized protocol for VCUG at all, with either performance or the recording of results. That varies drastically between clinics. Not every hospital and clinic even offers sedation to parents, even though it has been known to be a perfectly safe measure to take since the early 2000s. an actual VCUG radiologist with 25 years of experience, wrote an article all about that, and yet sedation is never regularly offered to parents as a safe measure. So doctors are not only lying to families, they're lying to their staff. This woman, I will link her article for you in case anyone wants to read it themselves, has incredible courage and speaks with conviction and humility and level-headedness to inform the public back in 2012 that she was trained throughout her residency to believe this test is not painful at all. She said she believed it. In fact, she took pride in calmly reassuring parents while their child is naked and screaming on a table with an active UTI infection, is not actually in pain. She believed it. That is not her fault. That's what she was taught for many, many, many years. And for many years, she performed this test with that belief. She no longer holds that view, which is why she said she began to offer sedation to more and more parents who seemed exceedingly grateful. I am so moved that one radiologist in this country took the time to acknowledge the wrongdoing and do everything in her power to fix it, while also not abandoning the patients that she has helped since. In terms of alternatives, there is one that is essentially performed the exact same way as the VCUG. This is not ideal, but it begs the question, why is this not offered at most clinics? And why do some physicians actively advocate against it? At Unsilenced, we can only imagine that this resistance stems from a place of profitability. There are some interesting economic factors involved in the administration of this test as well. The only difference between this and VCUG is the lack of ionizing radiation. That is the single risk that the majority of websites list for VCUG. There is an alternative measure that eliminates that risk, which is significant because children's bodily tissues are tenfold as sensitive to radiation as adult bodies. While we will never stop fighting for a better alternative that is not traumatizing, that is not the equivalent trauma as a violent rape, we're also wondering why things like this and the other alternatives that have been established as safe to perform and have comparable reliability, especially on a case-by-case basis, is never offered to parents and families. I've been running this movement for just a few months, and I've already had multiple moms reaching out to me to say they are angry that they were not told about these alternatives at the time because they would have gladly chosen them. For a comprehensive list of alternatives to VCUG, visit this link. We have a PDF ready to go for you guys to inform you about the risks and benefits and comparisons and all of that stuff. Please, please feel free to look at that and use it as a resource for you and your loved ones. That leads me to our third pillar stone here at Unsilenced, which is putting parents back in the driver's seat. It turns out that the vast majority of physicians have not been obtaining legally effective informed consent from parents and guardians prior to conducting a VCUG. In order for informed consent from a parent to be considered legally valid, the doctor is obligated by law to disclose all reasonable information about a given medical treatment or procedure or whatever service is being offered. Time and time again, doctors have failed parents. They failed me, and they failed hundreds of thousands of little girls. And this has been happening for generations, generations. I had my VCUG in 1997. At the time, a nurse encouraged my mother not to go through with it. She said, "This is traumatizing." As a 28-year-old adult, I now know why. Because there are numerous, not one, numerous studies prior to 1997 that clearly support uncanny similarities between VCUG and child sexual abuse. In fact, these similarities are so strong that VCUG patients, like myself and the girls I have met through this organization, were plucked out as stand-ins for victims of child sexual abuse in well-documented academic literature. So let me ask you this. Is the fact that VCUG patients have been repeatedly used in child sexual abuse studies not considered reasonable information to tell parents before they develop secondary trauma, watching their little girl catheterized against her will with an active UTI and told to piss herself in a room full of strange adults, most of them men? That is something parents deserve to know. That is necessary for informed consent to happen. I could go on and on about this because there are many things we are not disclosing to parents about VCUG. For example, the majority of medical websites, official medical websites that sell and market these services and make a living off of little kids with VUR, promote the VCUG test as routine, painless, harmless, and low risk, when in reality, dozens of studies have confirmed this test is very invasive, sexual in nature, entails painful and direct and intense genital contact, and results in the equivalent trauma of a violent rape. There are no excuses. We can do better. In fact, we could have been doing better for the past few decades. I have eagerly put all of my life plans on hold, put my marriage on hold, put our family on hold to run this organization and do everything it takes to make sure that parents understand the risks. Again, it is not up to me to tell parents what they should or shouldn't do with their child's health. I don't have that right. Neither do these doctors. By refusing to disclose all the information, they are doing families a disservice and they are breaking the law. They are breaking the law. It is that simple. You may have noticed a lot of hateful comments in our content lately. That is because we are facing the same pushback that the people before us have faced as well. And we are here to say, no more. No more. We have the evidence. We have it. So when people are willing to stop cussing us out online and actually look at the studies, I can't help them. But parents, I can help you. And I'm so glad if you're watching this. Thank you. Share it with your friends, with your loved ones, with your family members. It's very important. This has been happening for decades. It's not going to happen again on my watch. We're not going to go through another year of this. Parents deserve to know. Because given the opportunity, I would gladly go back and undo that thing from happening to me. It has led to chronic illnesses. It has led to domestic violence. It has led to abusive relationships. It has led to rape. It has led to 3 separate instances of sexual assault. I could go on and on and on about my scatterbrained childhood that isn't very cohesive because I had PTSD the entire time. How do I know that for sure? Because I relived the bodily sensations of that procedure for the first 6 months after finding out. I struggle less with those now, but they still come up, I'd say at least once a week. This is a living nightmare. And our organization is going to do everything we can to save other kids from that same fate and welcome and invite adult survivors to join us in healing and community, because that's the least we deserve now. I'm here because I'm angry and I'm grieving and I've suffered losses that are absolutely unfathomable to me at 28 years old. And I'll be damned if I have to bring children into this world knowing that this test is regularly performed, opening the door to sexual abuse on part of doctors, and destroying families. I won't do it. So I'm here to say it again and again and again. We will not be silenced.